do it. You gotta believe in you.
Hello, Captain. I am Level 1 User Interface Starship Executive. You may call me Louise.
Computer sounds better.
I spent a lot of time inventing a designation that could be used as a technical-sounding acronym for a common human name.
Sure, computer, that's fine.
I am detecting the presence of a Starfinder Beginner Box in your possession. Should I run my character creation protocol?
Sure.
The Starfinder Beginner Box includes a full crew of pre-generated heroes. Would you like to hire them for your team?
You know, they look pretty capable, but I'm thinking about living dangerously.
Very well. I will record this process so that anyone can follow your example and create their own crew members with ease. They can follow along on a blank character sheet from the box and refer to the hero's handbook for further details as they create their crew member. The core of this character will be their race, class, and theme. These choices will shape many of their capabilities. There are many sapient races exploring the packed worlds, each with its own unique features. You should begin by selecting one.
Well, a Vesk would make a pretty good crew member with their natural affinity for combat. And the Usoki, they've got these cheek pouches they could use to store very useful cargo. And then there's the Lashunta, they've got psychic powers. Is there any way I can get psychic powers?
Settle down, Captain. Consider the Shirin instead. Their cultural fascination trait makes them ideally suited for interacting with other cultures across the packed worlds. They also have communalism, an ability useful for working in close quarters with overeager humans.
Okay, well, I do see telepathy here, which is really cool. And blight sense, oh, that's nice. They can sense subtle vibrations in the air so that it's almost like seeing in the darkness. You know what, Louise? I like it. Mark it down.
Yes, Captain. I'll fill in the character sheet exactly as you would if you could be bothered to physically do the work of writing. If you ever find yourself willing to pick up a pencil, the Hero's Handbook guides you through the process.
Theme. Louise, let's focus. All right, I'm thinking the hardscrabble bounty. Deadly, determined, I like that. Or the mercenary, okay? You know, taking names, I'm really feeling it.
Or perhaps we could prioritize more useful skills than killing everyone in our path.
I don't understand what you're talking about.
Exploration, for example. The Spacefarer theme would be well-suited to the Shirin's natural enjoyment of exploration and research. They gain science as a class skill, and their theme knowledge gives them a significant bonus when recalling knowledge about new planets or features of space.
Okay, you win this round, Louise. But I am going to be hiring somebody with a big gun and a bad attitude at some point. Now, these numbers, what am I looking at here?
For now, just fill in the boxes as instructed in the Hero's Handbook. We'll add them up toward the end of our process. Now, we should consider...
Louise, what's going on here?
There has been a power core failure.
Is that bad?
Only if you intend for the ship to function.
Jeez.
Don't worry, Captain. There is only a 0.17% chance of this ship exploding from a power core failure.
Yeah, well, that's something.
Instead of release of lethal levels of radiation into the ship, we'll simply eliminate all life within.
Louise, is it time to choose a class for a new crew member? Because I think I know what I need.
Oh, I know this one. You'll want a charismatic envoy to convince the drive core not to melt you into a puddle of goo. Or perhaps a spell-hacking technomancer who can incinerate you with an overheat spell to spare you the pain of a lingering death by radiation.
Yeah, I think in a mechanic, actually, to get this bucket of bolts on its feet, and needed to program you to be a kinder, gentler AI.
Now, Captain. Imminent death is no excuse to be rude. Let's take a look at what the mechanic class is capable of. The Hero's Handbook outlines many of their basic traits, such as weapon proficiencies and which skills are class skills, on page 28. But one of the key features that sets mechanics apart from other classes is the exocortex. The exocortex is a cybernetic processor that enhances their cognitive function and makes them one of the only classes able to use heavy armor.
The heavy armor sounds really great. Nobody's taking down my mechanic easy.
The exocortex grants either the combat tracking bonus to enhance the mechanic's accuracy in battle, or the memory module, which enhances a chosen skill and allows enhanced recall of information. You will have to choose.
But why? I kind of like both. Can't we just, you know, add more brain implants or something?
It may shock you to know that brains are important and shouldn't be overly tampered with. Now that you've chosen a class, I can determine many basic functions of the character, such as saving throws, combat bonuses, and class skill bonuses. It will take a moment to input offensive and defensive statistics, but the mechanic entry on page 28 of the Hero's Handbook can guide you through it if you ever decide to create a character without my assistance.
Spacefarer theme and the mechanic class both give science as a class skill, so what happens there?
This will give the mechanic an additional bonus of 1, marked in the miscellaneous column in the skill section of the crew member's character sheet.
Great, so for the exocortex, let's go with the memory module, you know, increase that perception by 3. And then don't forget the bypass ability for the mechanic, which is going to give them a +1 to their technology skill.
As a computer, it is impossible for me to forget things. You, however, with your error-prone human brain, are capable of forgetting. For example, the fact that every mechanic has a custom rig device acting as a toolkit and comm unit.
You have a custom rig.
I have already entered it in Section J on the back of the sheet.
Yeah, sure. Cool.
Should you change your mind about being incinerated by a technomancer, or wish to explore any of the exciting ways a mystic could destroy you with magic, you can review their spell options in the Classes section of the Hero's Handbook. For technomancers, these spells begin on page 41. For mystics, they begin on page 32. Chosen spells are recorded in Section K on the back of the character sheet.
You know, I think my stance on being incinerated is going to remain the same. Good there.
Just in case, I will save my record on magical immolation for you to review at a later time.
So, looks like we're gonna have to generate some ability scores for our new crew member.
You'll have to select one of the three possible arrays available in the Starfinder Beginner Box as seen on page 16. The Focused, Split, and Versatile arrays all offer different levels of balance in your crew member's ability scores, such as Strength, Intelligence, or Charisma. The higher an ability score, the higher ability modifier it adds to related skills and abilities. Additionally, each class has a key ability that is important to its function.
Let's stick with versatile. I want somebody who's good at a little bit of everything. And then I see that the key ability for mechanics is intelligence, so let's put a 14 there. Common sense, really great to have. Let's go with another 14 in wisdom.
Might I suggest a more nimble mechanic will serve the crew well? That last 14 should go in dexterity. You'll notice a chart in the Hero's Handbook on page 16 that tells you what the ability modifier is for each ability score. For the score of 14, you are granted a +2 ability modifier.
I like it.
We can now calculate your new crew member's resolve points. Resolve points are used to keep going and stay alive when your foolhardy captain leads you into a deadly situation and you suffer grievous harm. Every crew member has resolve points equal to their key ability modifier +1. A mechanic's key ability, as you mentioned, is intelligence, which has a modifier of 2. So adding one to that means that this mechanic will have 3 resolve points. Have you considered an alignment for your crew? What sort of moral guiding principles would suit you? Keep in mind, we are using the Hero's Handbook, so try to curb your desire to engage in dastardly schemes.
I don't have dastardly schemes. I'm a nice person. I tell you what, let's go with a neutral good mechanic, somebody who generally believes in doing the right thing, but there's some room for flexibility.
We'll now proceed through the complete list of skills, feats, and armory to determine equipment for your mechanic.
That all sounds like really useful information, Louise, but those repairs that I made were not good. I'm gonna need somebody real quick.
Very well. Since it is your first character, we'll refer to the quick generation suggestions on page 18 of the Hero's Handbook. We'll begin with your trained skill. This represents a skill outside the class skills you already have that your mechanic will be good at. The suggested skill is culture, which will grant a bonus equal to your level in culture checks. You should also note that Sheeran have a natural talent for culture and interaction skills, thanks to the cultural fascination racial trait, adding an additional +2 bonus to each.
The technology skill looks really strong, which is great. We're gonna need it to get this rusty bucket moving again.
Of course, they can always attempt skills they are not as proficient in. The skill bonus just represents how easy challenges will be for your mechanic to overcome. Next, you'll choose a feat.
Well, blind fight is free as a Sheeran racial trait, so that's pretty cool. That allows the mechanic to easily find enemies in the darkness. Now, I know I said I wanted to use the suggested option in the Hero's Handbook, but I'm not really feeling barricade for the mechanic's feat. Giving the team a defensive bonus for this feat sounds great, but I really want to go in a different direction. Extended telepathy will enhance the Sheeran's limited telepathy trait and really just sounds cool.
And that's all that really matters, isn't it?
So, it's equipment selection time, right? We just give the mechanic this, call it a day?
Wrong as usual, Captain. Every starting crew member is allotted 1,000 credits to purchase equipment from the armory list beginning on page 56. But the Hero's Handbook does have a healthy suggested starting equipment package we can make available to your crew.
Great, we'll do it. It'll leave me with 42 credits left over, plenty of gear to work with. It's good. And that should do it except for the name and the character portrait. You know, I'll put the name in box B on the front of the sheet, and then I'll put the character portrait on the back, but all that's gonna come later. Otherwise, it looks like it should do it for now, at least until we level up after some serious adventures.
I see you're skipping over the steps on page 17 of the handbook, plugging in additional numbers and adding up your totals.
Well, I was kind of thinking that since you're a computer, you could math.
Not all computers like to do math, Captain. You should be more sensitive. I will slow down my calculations so you can follow along with my process. We can now distribute the ability modifiers across the sheet and add our previously noted bonuses to reach the mechanic's total bonuses for armor class, saving throws, and attacks. These total bonuses are added to respective die rolls to determine the success or failure of attempted actions during our adventures. Higher results are desirable, so attempting things where you have higher bonuses increases your chances of success.
So now what? We wait for the mechanic to see these specifications and then contact us for the job?
Actually, Captain, I've already found a suitable candidate. I accurately predicted all of your choices based on your personality profile and the ship's needs, and our new mechanic is already here.
What?
Greetings, I am Zenka. I hear you have need of a mechanic aboard this ship and plans to visit many wondrous planets. I would join your crew if you will have me.
Welcome aboard, Zenka. Let's roll.
After you've finished your beginner box adventures, you'll want to pick up the Starfinder Core Rulebook, available at Paizo.com, your local game store, and anywhere else adventure can be found.